As soon as she took my temperature, I was rushed to the hospital. Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel, Ellie McKitty. Today's video is a story time video, kind of like a little update video, I guess, because this happened about a week ago, and I'm filming this on Thursday, and I upload every Friday, so you're probably seeing this video a day after I filmed it, if you watch it the day I upload it, and that means by the time you're seeing this, it happened about 8 or 9 days ago. So anyways, today's story time video is about how I was rushed to the hospital about a week ago. So it started out a normal day. If you don't already know this and you don't watch my pet channel, I have 8 dogs. Go watch my pet channel if you don't already. It's called Pack Adventures. I post every Monday on that channel. And I post every Friday on this channel. So anyways, I have 8 dogs. I had 2 of them in the car with me. They're my 2 favorites, so the 2 I usually take everywhere with me. Chip and my puppy, 11. And my mom was at home, and I was in the car with Miss Burgess. We were going to get some Smithy Burgers. If you don't know what Smithy's is, I think it's only here in Ashe County where I live, but I could be wrong. But Smithy Burgers are pretty much just like slaw burgers. They come with mustard on them. But I usually don't get mustard on mine. I usually ask for them to not put mustard on mine because I don't like mustard. But yeah, that's what that is. But anyways, we were going to get Smithy Burgers and bring them back and eat them. And I just had the dogs in the car with me, you know, going on a little car ride. I didn't plan on taking them anywhere for a while. They were just with me for the little car ride, I guess. But on the way there, I kept getting sick to my stomach and we kept having to stop. And it just kept getting worse and worse. Like, we would have to stop so much, and every time the car would start back up, I would just feel sick again. And by the time we got there, I couldn't handle the whole entire car ride back home, so we ended up going to the dog park to eat and seeing if my stomach would be better by the time we were done eating. So we got our food and we went to the dog park. I let Chip and 11 play, and we just sat on the benches and ate our food. They met some new dogs, and we actually had the kittens with us because we didn't think we were going to go to the dog park. So we had to hold the kittens the whole time because we didn't know if the other dogs there liked cats or not. So we had the 2 baby kittens that I'm keeping. Once again, if you don't watch my pet channel, one of my cats just had 7 kittens, and I'm keeping 2 of them. Actually, I don't think I've said on that channel yet that I'm keeping 2 of them, but I am. So go watch my channel if you don't already. And if you still see this video, don't spoil it to everybody else that I'm keeping 2 of them. But anyways, so we held the 2 kittens while we ate. They just pretty much sat on our shoulders. And Chip and 11 ran around in the dog park and met some other dogs. They met like a pit bull, I think. And then there was like a German Shepherd Husky mix that they met. And then there was like a little small mixed breed that they met. The pit bull was adorable. People say pit bulls are mean, but they're not. And this pit bull barked like a little puppy. And he was sweet to my dogs. But anyways, I had felt a little bit better after we ate, so we went ahead and went home. But by the time I got home, I felt better, but then later on in the day, I just got worse and worse and worse and worse. Now, me and my boyfriend were both scared because we actually thought I had sepsis because I recently had an infection in my finger. It was still infected when this happened. And if you don't know, any kind of infection can spread into your bloodstream, which can cause sepsis, which kills 1 in 5 people, even with early treatment. So it's really not a good thing to have. I probably wouldn't have like survived if I did have that. And finger infections spread a lot faster than other infections. So me and him both thought I had sepsis, so we were scared. And he almost called the cops earlier that day because I told him I did have it because I thought I did. But then my mom tested me for it and I didn't have it. But we knew something was wrong with me. At this point, I didn't think it was sepsis anymore, but I knew something was wrong with me. So, you know, I didn't feel all that bad. My face was hot, but my body was like cold. I was definitely running a fever because that's a sign of running a fever. And I was just groggy and achy, and my stomach was still killing me. And so Miss Burgess gave me some Sprite and some medicine and told me to rest and see if I felt better. But I told her I was on a temperature, so I insisted she take my temperature. And when she did, it was like 105 or 106, I think, which is high enough for you to have a stroke. So as soon as she took my temperature, I was rushed to the hospital. And I got off the phone with my boyfriend, and he went to bed. And I was rushed straight to the hospital. So we got there. I could hardly walk by the time we got there. And Miss Burgess kind of helped me into the hospital and sat me down in the chair and checked me in. Got my hospital bracelet. I was only in the waiting room for like 5 minutes or so. I was the only person there, though. So they called me back. I went back. Well, one nurse called me back and took me back there, and then I didn't see her anymore after that because she left, and then the next nurse came in. The next nurse that came in, she was a really young nurse, but she was a really, really nice nurse, and she was the one that was with me most of the hospital visit. And I was there for like 5 hours, and I didn't get home until after 3 o'clock in the morning, but we'll get to that later. So it was like 10 or 11 o'clock when we arrived. Yeah, it was like 10 o'clock when we arrived, a little after 10. And so, you know, she did the basic things, took my blood pressure, and like, like, you know, the thing that goes on your finger, which is a pulse ox, it checks your pulse, and then like the blood pressure thing, which is the thing that squeezes your arm, and then like my temperature she took, it was not as high as it was at the house, so that's good. So then I told them my symptoms, and then they took like 5 vials this big of my blood, and I almost passed out because I never seen somebody take that much blood out of my body. So I had to get a blood sample and a urine sample. I had to go to the bathroom and get a urine sample, and then I had to get an IV. And I think you might still be able to see, this is not a high quality camera, but I can still see the red mark a little bit, and then there's a little bit of a bruise around it, so you can probably see the bruise in the middle of the bend of my arm. But if not, I'm sorry. But if you can see it, it's just a little bit of a bruise right in the middle. Right here in the middle. But anyways, I had to get an IV. And I was on that IV for like 5 hours. Like the whole time I was there. And so after they took my blood and they got my IV set up and they took my urine sample, they left the room for a while. I was still wide awake. And I just waited until this other nurse came in. She was an older nurse. She wasn't as nice, but she was still nice. And she took me to get CT scanned. And this was a wild adventure. The CT scan was just a wild adventure. So if you don't know what a CT scan is, you lay on a bed, and there's this giant machine. It's like a donut shape that you go inside of. The bed lifts you up and goes inside of the CT machine, and it like laser scans you to see if there's anything wrong with you. And I've had one done before, but not quite how I had it done then, and it was a little scary. So they did it, just my body, how I'm used to having it done first. And then I actually had to put my whole face under there and hold my breath. And they would tell me, like, when to breathe and when to hold my breath. And I never had it done that way. And I was actually scared of lasers, so I kept my eyes closed. I don't know if you were supposed to, but I did because I was scared of the lasers. And then I had to hold my arms above my head like this on the bed. And they put contrast dye in my IV, which is pretty much just something that makes your veins show up better in the CT scan. But she said it would make my whole body feel a little warm, and it would make me feel like I was peeing in my pants, but I wouldn't pee, it would just feel like I was. And then she said it might give me a metallic taste in my mouth, and that did not sound natural at all to me. And I was thinking, what are they putting in my body that's going to make my body be doing all these crazy things? I was a little scared, but It didn't feel as bad as she made it out to be. I guess she was just warning me because that can happen to some people, but I felt a little warm, like, in my stomach and abdominal area, but that's about it. And then after she put that in there, I did a CT scan with that in the veins, and then she closed up my IV tube so I didn't bleed out, obviously. And then took me back to my room, where I waited again. And then the nice nurse came back in, took my blood pressure again with the arm thingy. She did that multiple times while I was there. And they actually gave me, like, warm blankets, because they have blanket, like, heater things there, like warmers. And they give you fresh, warm blankets ever so often. And I was freezing because they warned me that the IV might make me cold, and it did, because I was getting a lot of fluids through the IVs. So they brought me like 3 heated blankets, so it was really nice. But I fell asleep hanging off of the hospital bed because the headrest was up like this, and so it was embarrassing. I didn't know I fell asleep with my legs hanging off the bed, but the really nice nurse came in and she actually reclined it the rest of the way for me and gave me some medicine in my IV and gave me a pill to take. And then she left the room again and we had to wait like a whole nother hour for my results to come in. And I slept good after that because my bed had been reclined. It was actually a stretcher that I was laying on, but I slept good after that because it had been reclined. And then I just remember waking up to her putting more medicine in my IV, and I just remember I almost threw up because I was asleep, and I just woke up to more medicine being put in my IV and almost threw up, but I didn't. I held it together, but I did have to use the bathroom. So the nurse, she was really nice. She took me to the bathroom, she knocked on the door, she opened the door, and then she put more toilet paper in there for me, and then she left, and I used the bathroom. And then when I came out, there was a doctor in the hospital room talking to Miss Burgess. So I went back in the hotel room, in the hospital room, and the doctor was talking to her, and it turns out I had a UTI, which is a urinary tract infection, and I had colitis, which is a colon infection. So I don't know how I got those infections. They said it could be viral, which it probably is viral for me because I've never had it before. So I was prescribed with antibiotics. I was prescribed with antibiotics and prednisone, but they only gave me like 3 prednisones because I took like 1 a day for 3 days, and then I took like with the antibiotics, I took 2 a day for 7 days. I just finished them yesterday, which if you're watching this video the day I uploaded it, it's 2 days ago that I finished taking it. And yeah, I'm feeling better now. I still have diarrhea because the antibiotics actually make it worse, but the antibiotics actually make the diarrhea worse, but they make the colitis and the UTI better. So I have an appointment with a doctor, a different doctor that specializes in this kind of stuff in June. And if I'm not better by then, I'm going to have to get a colonoscopy, which I've never had a colonoscopy, and I really hope I don't have to have one. Because that's like a full-on surgery where you're unconscious. So I really don't want to have one, but I might have to have one. But they're going to go check me out in June and see if I'm better or if I do need a colonoscopy. So yeah, that was pretty much it for today's video. That was my story time. And kind of like an update on my health. I'm still very, young and healthy, but I've always had some stomach problems, so it's not anything very surprising for me. I was scared, though, because I didn't know what it was when I was rushed to the hospital. But yeah, that's pretty much it for today's video. Just a little story time about what happened and what's going to continue to happen with my health for now. But I guess that was it. So don't forget to like and comment and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next Friday.